Recently, I came across a rare case of interstitial lung syndrome. What is interstitial lung syndrome? See, when we talk about the lung, we think of only lungs, which is a major part of the respiratory system. But if you take the lungs, there are just like a bunch of grapes, alveoli, thin walled structures are present with a space inside, which is being occupied by the air. But the whole thing has to be supported by connective tissue, which is called interstitial connective tissue, which is made up of fibers, elastic collagen fibers, and nerves, blood vessels will be passing through this. So this is called interstitial tissue in between the alveoli, to support the alveoli, to supply blood actually, and also nervous system. There is a connective tissue that is called interstitial connective tissue. This actually became thick. The interstitial connective tissue became so dry. Once it became dry, the alveoli was not able to collapse or it is not able to breathe properly. So it has lost its capacity to hold the air and also breathe. But because of this, he had lot of problems. He was not able to breathe at all. Breathing difficulty was there. But this is a rare disease for which there are no medicines at all. But what happened was, doctors have advised him to go for steroids only. He was under steroids for a pretty long time. But steroid has got lot of side effects. But still he was able to manage with the steroids only. But only thing is, he was asked to go for walking, etc. Walking also has got lot of difficulties. But only thing is, when he came to me with this problem, I just did not bother about the passage of the air. I concentrated on the interstitial tissue, connective tissue, which is supporting the alveoli. Alveoli are thin walled structure being supported by the thin collagen fibers and elastic fibers, and also alveoli are getting the blood supply and also nerve supply through this only. So connective tissue is there to support the entire lungs. So this has to be treated, for which I went for Reiki, that is Agni Chakra. Lungs are being supported by, or lungs are connected to the Anahata Chakra. But Anahata Chakra is not the only chakra that is connected to the respiratory system. The air passage should be proper. So for allowing the air to continuously flow into the lungs and also reach the connective tissue, I started concentrating on the Agni Chakra, which clears the nose. Nasal block is cleared. So once the nasal block is cleared, enormous amount of energy will go through the passage, that is in the throat region. Then it enters into the chest region where the bronchi are present. But because the interstitial connective tissue is collapsed, the alveoli are not able to breathe properly, hold the air. So for which I had to go to the Anahata Chakra, which takes care of the not only alveoli of the lungs and also connective tissue supporting the alveoli, that is interstitial tissue. So this actually has got the cure, or the recovery was faster. Initially he was not able to walk even for half an hour. And slowly when he came for the treatment, I treated him with Agni Chakra, Anahata Chakra and also Vishuddha Chakra. These three chakras are taking care of the respiratory system. In addition to this, lungs are present here. Entire lung is represented here. So I just concentrated on this region. There was painful points here. I treated here for the Sujoka acupuncture. Treated the nasal passage.